Today, I will explain how to the artificial intelligence image generation program called Stable Diffusion to Krita. Stable Diffusion is a free artificial intelligence-based image generation program. You can generate high resolution and unlimited images as long as your computer can. First, if you don't have Krita on your computer, you should install it. For this video, I set up a clean Windows. If any issues arise, we will address them. I will download it from Krita.org. Version 5.2 been released, and I was using it as a beta. I'm happy about that. I choose it because my operating system is Windows 11, but it also works on Linux and OS X. Krita is like an undiscovered treasure. I'm starting the installation. I'm continuing by clicking the next button. There's nothing special. I've sped up the installation video to save time. It usually takes 1 to 2 minutes. Krita has been installed and is working. I'm closing Krita and starting to install the plugin. I prepared the link for this beforehand. I will also add it to the description below. Just copying and pasting it into the browser. A new version of this is also available. I hope it has improved. I should mention that it's quite successful. I also installed the Stable Diffusion program separately. Although it's good for fine-tuning, I must say it's not as easy as this. I will download this zip file. It's only 606 kilobytes. When installed, it will be around 15 gigabytes. I will open this file in the folder where Krita plugins are located. This is important. I must open it in the correct folder. You should find this folder according to your username. If the AppData folder is not visible, check the Show Hidden Files option in the View menu. The target folder is named Krita. I'm opening the zip file here. Let's open Krita. I select settings from the menu and then Python plugin manager. It should appear here. I need to activate it and restart the program. I'm activating settings, dockers, and iImage generation. It didn't work. I should create a blank file first. Yes, it's open now. I press the configure button. Here you can see where the installation will take place. It requires at least 10 gigs of space. Since my graphics card is NVIDIA, Hughes should be selected. I'm pressing the install button. The rest should be installed automatically. It takes a little time. I will fast forward the video here and there. The installation is complete, but it gave an error. I think I made a mistake here. I had performed a clean Windows installation. I didn't update the graphics card driver. I believe the error is due to this. I will update my graphics card and try again. The graphics card driver is installed. I'm trying again. Yes, it worked. Two checkpoints have been loaded. One is for photorealistic images, and the other is for imaginary drawings. You can also load different checkpoints later. Let me write something simple. Let's draw a cat. It seems to be missing a leg. These things usually happen. Let me try something more complex. While it's working, let me take this. Let me enlarge these layer images so we can see them more clearly. The image has arrived. This is not very good. I'm adding it to a layer by pressing the apply button. It was just a preview a moment ago. I will keep the prompt the same and try changing the checkpoint. I might resort to a little trick. My Chapt account is not active on this computer right now. For now, I'll manage with Bing. But Chapt is definitely more successful. It's struggling a lot. I'm copying this and pasting it into Krita. It looks a bit better. Let me try something else. I ask it for a literal landscape of a fantasy world this time. By the way, our previous crystal drawing is complete. I was expecting a drawing closer to digital art, but it's not that beautiful. Therefore, you should try downloading different checkpoints from Sifttt.com and experimenting. DreamShaper 10 Kels yields better results. While DreamShaper 8 is only 2 GB, 10 Kels is 6.4 GB in size. Generating images also takes a long time, but the results are more satisfying. So, I recommend experimenting with different models. I'm saving the file. There's nothing more to do at a basic level. You can try it out for yourself. I've put in quite an effort to create these kinds of images. Thank you for watching. In the rest of the video, I'm leaving a few examples of the images I created using this method. Thank you.